Hello, I'm Andy, and I'm going to read to you a weekly horoscope, and that's from July the 16th up to July the 22nd, and it's for you coming from Sagittarius. Let's start with the 16th of July, which is a very, very good day for you, especially in the morning and afternoon and early evening period. It's a Sunday, and so you're going to be very happy with whoever you are with. If you want to be with your business people playing golf, I recommend that. If you want to increase the bonding with your colleagues and bosses, I recommend that. If you want to be with your marriage, family or romance partner, wonderful. So treat this morning, afternoon and early evening periods as very progressive and wonderful for you. The evening and nightfall period, some problems can come up. They can include something about money or expenses. They can include the differences of opinion. They can improve ego problems. They can improve romance or love areas which are a bit touchy. So watch out that the evening nightfall period, whoever you are with, you cannot afford to be stubborn or use words which are hurtful or sarcastic. That can produce the problems. The 17th of July starts in a very gloomy, slow and sometimes depressing fashion. Problems of the past can trouble you. People of the past you don't like may contact you or produce a burden for you. And your elders may not be well, or things like that are going to make you feel down. Morning, afternoon, early evening period. It's a Monday, you probably will be at work. Or if you're in business, you could be conducting business. So you need to focus on what is important. Otherwise, you're going to find that the morning, afternoon, nothing gets done. And then blame can come and make things worse. The evening and nightfall period becomes excellent and you become very lucky. And whoever you are with, you find solutions where earlier in the day you could not find, and the afternoon and early evening period just left you solutionless. And now you can find the solutions coming. And the socializing is going to produce plenty of benefits. So go out with the people you do business with or with from whom you're looking for business. Go out with your colleagues, go out with your bosses, or definitely be out with your marriage partner and family people or your romance partner. The night ends beautifully for you. The 18th of July, the planets are good in the morning afternoon period, but they make you over determined, over pushy, over expectant of what others should do for you. And this sort of thing, you'll get what you want, but why don't you take the soft approach? And that way, taking the soft approach, you will get the support as well, but you will have the love as well from people. And it's going to be a good morning, afternoon period. Arrange meetings in your business, in your job-wise. Go out for lunch with your marriage partner, romance partner. Except, take it easy and take the soft approach. The nightfall period and the early evening period are not very good. Tends to be a bit gloomy. You could be disappointed as your plans get cancelled or your plans get postponed, so watch out. Double check all this even in the evening session. Nothing remains to your favor in the sense that disappointment must be seen. So if you are on top of it and be alert, you can minimize all this. Watch out that something from your past, some people from your past may meet you or contact you with bad news, or that some news of the past also may be not very good. It's this kind of a gloomy frustration evening and nightfall period. The 19th of July, Wednesday, starts very well for you, but don't be arrogant, don't be egoistic. Otherwise, you may lessen the good news waiting. It's a working day, it's a Wednesday, you will get good news at your place of work, you will get praise, and you can be the person who is the shining at your shining hour. And you will be chosen for something very important. Your ego wants that and wants to receive that. And you'll find support from your colleagues, from your bosses. And you'll find good news in business areas if you're in business. And if you want to go out for lunch with your marriage partner, family, or with your romance partner, do so. People are looking up to you. Evening and nightfall period, also good. But this combination of morning, afternoon, evening, nightfall periods, they are all fire planets. So they put you on fire very easily. If somebody's insulting to you, you whack it back, either in words or in action. So take the soft approach throughout the whole day. to keep the whole day, morning, noon and night good. Don't spoil it by suddenly being arrogant or too touchy, suddenly wanting to counter-attack in terms of argument. Don't do that. Otherwise, a little spoiling factor will creep in. 20th of July is a very good day. Many emotional planets are there, but these planets bring imagination, they bring creativity, they allow you to plan the move you want to make in your career, in business. And being emotional planets, try to be even for lunch with your marriage or romance partner or family people. Most important is you are going to find opportunities to make the change or to bring out ideas which are brilliant. Evening and nightfall period are also good. Now you are being a person who wants good results, to meet people who are important, to socialize with people who are able to make you progress. So the last thing you want is to show arrogance. Try not to show that, and you will have a very good evening and nightfall session, even with your romance partner, with your marriage and family people. The 21st of July is an excellent day. In the morning, afternoon and even the evening period, these planets, they just give you good luck. You will get good luck, you will hear of it, you will show progress, being praised, the progress that you have made. Your business side, you will get plenty of good luck as well and good news. You can attract a new business partner or attract business contracts. Mix business and pleasure throughout the whole day, for lunch, for evening socializing, and you will see that much can be attained, much can be achieved. And if you are looking for romance, it's a perfect time to make your contact during the morning afternoon period. Evening nightfall period is a gang of emotional planets, also the planets who make you creative, also the planets who make you help plan changes. So you are doing extremely well in the evening and nightfall period as well. They can make you a bit moody, a bit oversensitive. Don't let that happen. Tell yourself in your heart, never mind, I'm sure they mean well. The 22nd of July, which is a Saturday, does not start well for you. Morning, afternoon periods, you get rebellious, or other people get rebellious. There is a sense of not getting things done because the unexpected in a negative form wants to visit you in the morning, afternoon and early evening period. So you got to be on your toes as little fires are cropping up everywhere, and make sure the fires don't crop up by not being rebellious and by towing rules and regulations. That means following rules and regulations. Don't be a person who wants to come up with ideas which are so out of this world that other people think that you are not sound, okay? And watch out that a danger of accidents can also appear, because the planet of unpredictedness is there and accidents are part of it. They can be emotional accidents, they can be accidents which are physical or mental accidents as well. So stick to the plan, don't want to create upsets. Go according to rules and regulations, whether in personal areas, whether in business areas, whether in career areas, and you'll be able to handle it. Evening and nightfall period becomes excellent. Now you're going to find solutions where earlier you couldn't. Now you're going to get the praise which earlier you couldn't get. Now you're going to get the support where earlier was denied of you. And the results will be very good. If you're working late, you get plenty of good news coming that way. Mix business and pleasure. Go out with business people. Go out and chase for the business contracts. And the evening nightfall period becomes so blessed, and you're going to achieve plenty of it. Well, that's my advice for you for the week. I'm already Skyping, and I'm charging USD 50 for a 90-minute Skype session. And during the Skype session, I'll be knowing your full date of birth and time of birth, and looking at your palms, looking at your face. I do face reading as well. And if you want me to use Kabbalistic tarot cards, I will. And for your next 5 or 6 years, I will be intensively looking at all areas of your life and advising you. And for those 5 or 6 years, all you're paying me is USD 50. Hardly comes to USD 10 ring, $10 for a year. What a good deal you are getting. Go to Facebook, follow me, ask me questions. Go to Skype, leave me a message. And if you want to email me, ask all the questions you want. But please, don't ask me a stupid question like, how accurate are you? What am I supposed to say? Okay, ask me sensible questions. Let's have a good dialogue, and let's settle down to a good Skype session for your next 5 or 6 years. Until then, thank you and good luck.